Mylar survival blanket. This stuff is pretty slick stuff. We'll be going over some different uses of it. I'll show you how to put up a quick shelter with it using this and just other natural materials. We'll also be maybe doing two shelters, maybe not, I don't know, depending on the time I have. I also want to show you how to do a rain catch and how to signal with it. So it's a pretty versatile piece of equipment. This one here, I'm not sure exactly what the size is on it. They're usually about, close to 5 foot by 6 foot-ish, right around in there. Pretty thin material, but we're going to make it do what we want it to do. Works great at reflecting heat, so I'm going to get a little area set up to do a shelter, and we'll put her up. All right, I've got a couple of trees spaced almost perfectly apart right there, just about 6 foot or so, maybe a little bit longer. Got my Mylar blanket laid out, survival blanket, and what I'm going to do is use those stakes. They're made out of cedar branches I just broke off real quick, and some basswood bark that I took a small branch off of and stripped that off, and show you how to do that kind of using both natural and man-made materials. And we're going to do a real quick pup tent. Alright, so I've got a piece of basswood bark. Got my Mylar blanket. I got the middle of it right here. I'm going to take a handful of just this grass right here. Oops. And I'm going to wad it up in a ball. I'm going to place that in my material since it doesn't have any grommets. I'm going to take this piece of basswood bark. I'm making it into a slip knot. I'm going to put that around that butt in the grass and tighten it down. Now, I'm going to wrap this around my tree. Put that down just a little bit. Wrap this around my tree and tie it off. I'm going to do the same thing to the other side. All right, I've got both sides tied up now. Grass buttons and basswood lashings. Now I'm going to stake out sides and show you how to do one, and then show you the finished product. All right, now I'm going to come over to this corner. This is going to be my stake. I'm going to kind of measure it out. About right there-ish. Do the same thing. Take some of my grass. Make a button. Place it in the corner. This will work with any type of tarp also, not just a space blanket, Mylar type deal. Tighten my slip knot. Again, measure it out. Put that stake in. I'm going to tie that baby off. All right, there's a pup tent type shelter. You can build a little bit lower to the ground, but that right there will keep the rain off you, and you can use it to funnel some water into maybe a plastic bag you had or something like that if it's raining on you. Once again, not a perfect shelter, but for something that comes in such a small package, it's not too bad. I took a couple minutes and just set this up into a lean-to type configuration. It works real well this way, especially if you have another tarp or a natural shelter to use this in conjunction with. It will reflect the heat of a fire back to you in the wintertime. You won't believe it. It's like you're in a little oven, so kind of like a mini reflector oven type thing. So this is another viable option. Once again, this is made with just basswood bark and cedar stakes, so it's nothing anybody else out there can't do. Alright, set up in this configuration, we can use this for a shade shelter in an arid environment, as long as we're not worried about any rain. But you can also use this for a rain catch. If you just bring those poles in a little bit closer and put a weight in the middle of it, it'll catch rain and hold water for you. You might have to dig a depression also, but I'm not going to go through the effort of digging a depression. I think you guys can figure that much out. Also, if you need this for a signaling device, this is how you want to rig it. You want to rig it elevated so it gives you shadow. It's also going to give you movement from the wind. You can see the wind moving it a little bit. You want it out in the open area where a plane or rescuers can see you. Also, the reflective nature of this is going to reflect the sun right back around and really make it pretty glary and easy to be spotted. One more thing that we're going to do with it is going to be make an emergency poncho out of it, and that'll trash it out. So it'll put a hole right in the middle of it, but that's all right. All right, for our poncho, I've got this thing folded in half. The duct tape off of my personal survival kit is going to be key for me here. I'm going to kind of find the middle. Stick in it. I'm going to place that duct tape right across there. Mylar, once it rips, goes pretty quick. So, we don't want it to rip. So now, I'm just going to put my PSK knife and be very careful. And that makes your hole your head. And since you've got that duct tape there, it keeps it from tearing. And I will model this in a second. All right, can you see how that neck is keeping that from tearing out? Then all you do is take and tie. I just tied another piece of bark around my waist. Pretty hot, but it'll get the trick done.